Hello student, how are you all? Today in this video we are going to start chapter number 16 of grammar and the name of chapter is subject and verb agreement. Student, before we start the chapter let us understand what is subject and what is verb. Student, a subject is a part of sentence that contains the person or a thing performing the action. Okay, subject is a part of sentence and it shows that a person or a thing is doing some action. Okay, वो ये दिखाता है कि कोई जो है वो action कर रहा है, या तो कोई person or a thing is doing some action. Okay, and verb is a word that expresses that action of a person or a thing in the sentence. And the work of verb is that it shows what the action is. Okay, it shows that what the action is done by a person or a thing in the sentence. So that is subject and verb. Now let us understand the chapter. Subject and verb agreement. See the rule. A rule of a subject and verb agreement is that a singular subject is followed by a singular verb and the plural subject needs a plural verb. It is also known as a subject and verb concord. See, the main rule of this chapter, main and the important rule of this chapter is that if the subject is singular, the verb also will be singular. And if the subject is plural, then verb also needs plural. Then the sentence will be correct. The opposites of this cannot be done. For example, if the subject is singular and verb is plural, the sentence will be wrong. And if the subject is plural, verb is singular, then all the sentence will be wrong. The correct is, if the subject is plural, verb also will be plural. If the subject is singular, verb also will be singular. This is what called the subject and verb agreement. See, by the example we will see. A child likes chocolate. Here, the child is the subject, which is singular form. So, the verb likes is also in a singular form. Subject is singular, verb is also singular. Children likes chocolate. Here children is subject, which is in plural form. Children means more than one. Okay, so the verb like is also in a plural form. Next example, I am an Indian. Here I is a subject which is singular. So with I we had used the verb am, which is singular. And next one, we are Indians. Here the subject we means it is plural form, more than one. So the subject also, sorry, verb also we had used are. Next example, Suresh plays the football every evening. Here Suresh is the singular person. Subject is singular, so verbs plays is singular. Suresh and Ali plays the football every evening. Here Suresh and Ali, two persons, means it is the plural form. So subject play is also, sorry, verb play is also in a plural form. Understood? If the subject is singular, verb also will be singular. And if the subject is plural, verb also will be plural. See, apart from the main rule mentioned above, there are a few more rules according to which the subject and verb agrees. Okay, this was the rule of subject and verb agreement. But apart from that, there are some other rules also in which we are using the subject and verb agreements. Okay, one by one we will see it. The first one, we use a plural verb when two or more subjects are connected by and. See, when there are two subjects in the sentence, okay, which is which means the if subject is two or more than two, we use plural verb. Okay, and when it is connected by and, okay, when the two subjects which are connected by and, or which when if the two or more subject which are connected by and, then the verb will be plural. For example, Ganesh and Geeta are cousins. Here Ganesh and Geeta, two names are there, two subjects, okay, and they both are connected by word and. Okay, so when the two subjects are connected by and, the verb will be plural form are. So are is a plural verb. Okay, subject is in subjects are two subjects here, Ganesh and Geeta. Okay, and they both are connected by the word and. So we had used a verb plural form, verb in a plural form are. Okay, see, discipline, hard works, and faith is oneself gives us success. Here, subject is more than two. See, discipline, hard work, and faith. These three words, but connected by the word and. Okay, so subject is more, two or more than that. Then we are using plural form and also connected by and. So here, the subject give is plural. Understood? First one rule is, if the subject is more than two or two, and both the words, both the subjects are connected by word and, then we use verb as in plural form. Rule number two. Two singular subjects connected by or requires the singular verb. See, when there are two subjects in a sentence, but both the subjects are in singular form. Okay, and they are connected with the word or, that time verb will be singular. See, for example, the milkman or the gardener rings the doorbell first. See, here two subjects are there, milkman or the gardener, and both of are singular. Milkman is also one, gardener is also one, and they both are connected by or, means any one will be there. इनमें से कोई भी एक बेल बजाएगा, सिंगुलर. ओके, सो सब्जेक्ट इज मोर देन वन, टू सब्जेक्ट्स आर देयर, बट बोथ द सब्जेक्ट्स आर सिंगुलर एंड ऑल्सो दे आर कनेक्टेड विद द वर्ड और, सब दैट इन सच केस वर्ब विल बी ऑल्सो इन सिंगुलर फॉर्म, रिंग्स. ओके, वर्ब इज रिंग्स विच इज इन सिंगुलर फॉर्म. सेकेंड वन एग्जाम्पल, शुगर or jaggery is used as the sweetener in the dish, in this dish. Okay, see here, sugar or jaggery, any one of that, singular. Both sugar is also a subject, jaggery is also a subject, from both are singular. So when the two subjects are there and both are singular, the verb will also is singular. That is why we has used is as a singular verb. Understood? This was rule number two. Rule number three. If there are expressions with, along with, as well as, besides, or not follow the subject, the verb always agree with the subject only. See, when there is a words like along with, as well as, besides, or not following the subject, or not following, at that time, we will use, the verb will always agree with the subjects only, not with any other words, but whatever the subject will be, according to that only the verb will agree. Okay, if the subject will be in plural form, the verb will be in plural form. If the subject will be in singular form, verb will be in singular form. For example, see, Sagrika along with his with her cousin is coming to our house this weekend. See, here the subject is Sagrika, singular. Verb is coming, is singular. Okay, see, Mini as well as Adil rises early in the morning. Here Mini with Adil, but singular, so rises is subject is also singular. See next one sentence, the ministers, not the presidents, are responsible for the crisis. Here ministers, plural form, subject is in plural form, ministers, so the verb is are, plural form. Okay, rule number four. See, the two singular subject connected by either or neither nor requires the singular verb. Okay, here by mistake, printing mistake, subject written, but it is verb there. Okay, the two singular subjects connected by either or neither nor requires the singular verb. Okay, if in the sentence or the subject is connected by either or neither nor, then subject sorry verb will be in singular. See, for example, either Malati or Sudha has won it. Okay, either it the two subject Malati and Sudha are connected with either or word, the word either and or. So when the words are connected with either or neither and nor, the verb will be in singular form. That is why has is a singular form. See, next example, neither Deepu nor Yasmin has won the gold medal. Okay, here second one sentence is connected, the two subjects are connected with neither and nor. So subject is verb is has in a singular form. Okay, whatever the subjects are connected with either or neither nor, subject verb will be always in singular form. Rule number 5. See, singular verbs are used for the pronouns each, everyone, everybody, anyone, anybody, someone and somebody. Okay, see, singular verb, when the subject is in pronouns which as each, everyone, everybody, anyone, anybody, someone and somebody, at that time verb will be in singular. Singular verbs are used with this pronouns. Okay, see, for example, each of us is a trained cook. Here each of us, but whenever such words are there, we are using singular verbs only. Here is an singular verb. Okay, second example, everyone is invited to the program. Though here everyone means it is more than one person, but whenever such words are there, whenever such pronouns are there, we are using singular verbs only. Okay, is invited. So the subject is everyone, verb is invited. The librarian got irritated when somebody talks. Here somebody talks is a pronoun used, so with that we are using singular verb, talks. Okay, so this was the fifth one rule. Next one, see, some sentence begins with there or here. In the sentences, the subject comes after the verb. In such sentences too, the verb agrees with the subject. See, there are many sentences in which the sentence begins with there or here. When such kinds of sentence, when they begins with there and here, in this cases or in this sentences, subject will be after the verbs. Okay, first verb will be there, then subject will be used. But still, the rule will remain same only. Okay, here the verb is first, but still, if the verb is subject is singular, verb will be also singular. If the subject will be plural, verb will be plural. There is no change in the rule for that. Okay, rule will remain same, though the placement of the subject and verb will be changed, but rule will be still applied the same one. For example, here is a rabbit. Here the subject is rabbit, but the verb is used first in the sentence, then at last we had used subject rabbit. But if the subject rabbit is singular, verb is also singular. There are a few rabbits. Here subject rabbits in plural form, so verb are is used for plural. Okay, there are 5 girls in the room. Here the subject is girls, which is in plural form, so verb are is also used as in plural form. There is one girl behind the door. Here girl, one girl means singular form, so the verb is, which is singular form. Okay, though the placement of the verb and subject is changed, but the rule is as it is. If singular subject, singular verb, plural subject, plural verb. Okay, last one rule, when the subject is a collective noun like team or community, we use singular or plural verb based on the meaning we want to convey. See, when there is a collective noun, okay, collective noun means a group of person called as in one. Okay, when it is a collective noun, then it depends what the type of sentence mean, what is the meaning of the sentence. According to that, the subject, the verb and subject agreement will be decided. Okay, though the same word can be used as a singular also and as a plural form also. So it depends according to the meaning of the sentence. See, for example, the team plays well. Here the word team is used as an singular form, means the whole team, but called as an one. Okay, so here team is used as a singular subject, so verb plays is used as a singular verb. But the same thing, the team are spending their leisure time in the countryside. Here the team is treated as a separate or individual, means all the players of the teams are spending their time, means here individual means more than one persons, so it becomes plural. So the subject team is plural. Here the verb are is used as a plural. Okay student, so these were some of the rules for the subject and verb agreement. Hope you would have got it. And the exercise part will be sent you as in a PDF form. Thank you.